Good morning all. Today we are going to see the software testing 5th unit. Topics covered in this video session are software test automation, skill needed for automation, scope of automation, and design and architecture for automation. So in unit 5, we are going to see only on the automation and the metrics and measurements. So whichever is been shown in red, we are going to see today. So first topic is software test automation. What is called as a software test automation? It is used to develop the software to test the software. That is, we are going to develop a software test tool whichever helps to test the software. So it can help address several problems. We see what are the problems. First problem is it can save time as the software can be executed with the test cases faster than the human tool. That is, whenever we need to run the test cases during the overnight, then we can make use of this automation test tool and we can save the time. And the next problem is automated tests can be more reliable and helps in immediate testing. That is, whenever test engineer executes a particular test case more number of times, what happens here? There is a chance for a human error, because of which some of the defects may come. So in that case, it can be more reliable. Next one is it helps in immediate testing. What is called as immediate testing? Automation gets the time gap between the development and the testing activities by creating the scripts that should be executed as soon as the product build is ready. Next one is it is useful for better utilization of global resources. That is, whenever we do the manual testing, we need the test engineer's presence. But in case of automated testing, it can be done by itself and also it should be available round the clock, that is 24 hours per day and also the 7 days per week. Next one is automation means end-to-end, not test execution alone. That is, we should not end with development activities as executing the test cases, that is the part of joining. That is, it starts with the automation. That is, next one is topics, that is terms used in automation. So what are the terms are there in automation? We can have two types of test cases. First of all, what is a test case? A test case is a set of sequential steps that is required to run a corresponding output based on the set of input given. So there are two types of test cases. One is automated test case. Next one is manual test case. A manual test case has been executed manually, while the automated test case is executed using automation. We can have two important dimensions, that is what operations have to be tested. Next is how the operations have to be tested. First one is how portion is called as the scenarios, and what the operation has to do is called as the product specific feature, and how they have to be run is called as the framework specific requirement. What is a framework specific requirement? It is one of the requirements. It has been needed for the framework to run a particular product that has been used by all the organization. And next term is the test suite. What is called as a test suite? We can have set of the test cases to be combined with the set of the scenarios. Then that is called as a test suite. This is the example of test cases used for testing. And right side, that is the second column, is the what type of testing we need to do. That is, first one is checks whether the login works, that is login operation, whether it is been working fine or not. That is the example of functionality testing. Next one is reliability testing. We can have the login operation itself to be repeated for a certain number of times. That is called as the reliability. Next one is load of stress testing. It will have some persons, that is from 1,000 clients or 10,000 clients need to perform the same login operation. So what will be the load or the stress testing? Next one is performance testing. So how the test case should be written? We need to measure the time taken for login operations in a different condition. That is the performance testing. Then what about the internationalization testing? That is, it should be depends upon the some of the other languages, that is Japanese language, we need to run the corresponding login operation. So these are the some of the sample test cases that belongs to what type of testing. So whatever we saw the terms used for the testing, we can draw the framework for test automation. In the middle part is the scenarios. It consists of the framework, are the test tool and the test cases. What is a scenario? It is the how they have to be executed. How the test cases have to be executed is called as a scenario that should be defined by the user. And next one is framework is how to execute the test cases. That is the framework for the test tool. And test cases is the what the test should do. Then these, the combine of this one is called as the scenarios. And test tool is the combination of scenarios and the test cases. That is, we need to have associated scenario for the corresponding automated test cases. That is called as the test tool. So this is the framework for test automation. Next topic is skills needed for automation. So what are the skills we can have for automation? So skills needed for test engineer, it depends on the number of generations of automation we can have in the company, depends on the current situation and in the future needs. So there are three types of generation. First generation is second generation and third generation. First generation is depends on the tool, record and playback. And second generation is the based on the tool, data driven tool. And third generation is action driven tool. Okay, we'll see one by one. First generation is record and playback. By the name record and playback, it can avoid the repetitive actions of executing the test cases. That is, what is the test engineer's job? He or she needs to record the sum of the actions through the keyboard characters or using the mouse clicks. So those recorded scripts can be played back later. These scripts may contain hard-coded values. That is, whenever we need to print the corresponding current date and the time, then it will be difficult for that scripts to be redone and rechanged. Then it requires the some of the manual intervention by the test engineer. So he or she needs to handle the error conditions. So whenever the application changes frequently, then what we need to do, all these scripts needs to be re-recorded and rerun, thereby increasing the maintenance cost. So this record and playback of test automation tools may not be effective in that case. Next one is data-driven tools. So this method, it will be useful to develop the test scripts that may generate a set of input conditions and also the expected output. That is, it takes some of the times and also the effort of the product to be produced by the organization, and is mainly focused on the input condition and the expected output. Here they have used the black box testing approach. Next tool is action-driven tool. This technique, they'll be mainly focusing on the actions. That is, whatever the actions appear on the application, that should be automatically tested based on some set of controls defined for the automation. Here, there is no input and output conditions to be required. So whenever we need to test a corresponding website, what we need to do, we need to first of all log in to the page, then we need to click some of the next pages. Then if you want to download some of the software, we need to click the action download. So user needs to specify the operations, that is login, next button, then download button and so on. Then other things that can be automated in the case of the test cases, and also it can be automatically generated. Then here it can have two aspects. One is based on the test automation and second one is based on the framework design. In case of framework design, we can have the sum of the set of requirements to be defined for the framework. Then we can follow it for the multiple products to be produced by the organization. So I just summarized this topic, that is skills needed for automation contains four levels in three generations. In four levels also, that is in third generation, we can have two levels. One is test automation, next one is framework design. Next topic is scope of automation. So whenever we need to have the automation in our SDLC lifecycle, what we need to do, we need to introduce our automation process in the requirement phase. So what happens here, that automation requirements can vary from product to product and also from situation to situation and also from time to time. So depends on that one, we need to identify the scope of automation. So here, first of all, I'll just divide that testing based on the automation. First testing is functional testing. Second one is performance testing with the help of automation. In functional testing, main thing is we need to use the, it will be useful in regression test case execution. So whenever we need to execute the test cases based on the regression test, in this functional testing with the help of automation it will be useful. And mainly it is useful in the software engineering, where we have learned that agile scrum methods, here they will be producing more frequent releases of the product. So what happens here, it is not possible to execute all the test cases in the regression test manually within a short time of period. So we can go for this automation. And also only one time report it is, that is only one script needs to be written. This script needs to be automated in the case of manual testing. So it gives a high ROI, that is return of investment. And also we need to keep 60% to 70% of regression test cases to be automated so that it can commit to the test case execution. Next one is performance testing with help of automation. So here all the application nowadays, what they are mainly dealing with the critical requirements. That is the main thing is they need to measure the application performance. So there are some certain set of tools available across the organization which can be helpful to do the performance testing with help of automation. Next one is load and stress testing. What is called as a load testing and what is called as a stress testing? Load testing is being performed to see whether the application can be capable of having the maximum load, whatever is being written in the SRS document. Here we need to start executing the application with the specified load, that is without overloading the application. Then in stress testing, we need to check whether it crosses that maximum load and it can withstand, that it can accommodate. Then what happens here, we need to find the breakpoint where it is being stopping than the maximum load, that is the load and stress testing. So how we can perform the load and stress testing? We need concurrent users to be logged in and also in multiple computers. But it is very difficult in manual testing because several users needs to log in. They need to give several load for several days. That is not possible. So by using the automated tool, we can monitor the CPU performance and also the memory usage of the testing the computer. And this tool, what happens, it can generate the number of artificial users. They will give the artificial load so that we can get the test accuracy. So that's all about the testing purpose, how it helps in automation. Next thing is automating areas less prone to change. That is, we need to concentrate on the areas whichever has less change in requirements or no change in requirement. Those areas needs to be automated first. So it should be considered, that is the basic functionality of the product to be considered first. So in that case, it will be useful for regression test case and also the smoke testing, which is mainly focusing on the daily bills. Next one is user interfaces and the non-user interfaces. Next one is automated tests that pertain to standards. So here, so products which we are going to develop it, that should be compliance to standards. So what is compliance to standards? Whenever product we can have that is providing ODBC or JDBC interface, they should satisfy a ODBC or a JDBC test. So what happens here? Automating for these standards, they will come with the help of test suite should be developed for the product. So they will come in the form of a set of tools. That set of tools to be sold to the commercial markets. Then for testing these standards, we should have the legal and the organization requirements. That is, in order to certify, this is the software, this is the hardware, we are going to release it before the project release, we need to certify that. So this process is called as the certification testing, that can be done by certification suites. Next one is management aspects in automation. That is, how we are going to get the management commitment whenever we do the automated test cases. So they mainly focus on the return on investment. That is, whenever we can start our automation, we can do two things. One is we need to concentrate on the areas whichever has the high permutation and the combination. That is a good area we need to concentrate on it. And next one is we need to have the test cases to be automated in a less time and also in an easy manner. So the second case also should be considered so that we can get the high return on investment for the automation. Next one is, we also need to consider the basic functionality of the product to be automated. So in this case, we can have the test cases to be prioritized, that is high priority and medium priority and low priority based on the customer expectations. And automation also should focus on the high priority one, then come to the medium one, then come to the low base priority requirements. So that's all about your scope of automation. First of all, you concentrated on the testing, then automation to the needs to be prone to change, then less prone to change. And third one is automation pertaining to standards, and fourth one is management aspects for automation. Next topic we are going to see the design and architecture for automation. Here, what is called as a design? It is very important concept. It is because it has been capturing all the requirements in the modules and the interactions between the modules. First of all, I can have the pictorial representation of this design and architecture. Center part is the automation framework, and these are the external modules. And whatever the links are shown, right, this arrow marks, thin arrows is being shown as the internal interfaces, and thick arrows is being shown as the external interfaces. And then we can have some of the topics to be covered. First one is external modules, that is TCDB and DefectDB. TCDB is test case database and defect database. And we are going to see the configuration file and the scenarios. And first topic is that one. Then second one is test cases and test framework. Then next one is tools and the results, how it has been helpful for the test framework. And report generation and reports and metrics. So we are going to see each topic in detail. First one is external modules. So in external modules, we can have two modules. One is TCDB and DefectDB. TCDB is test case database. Second one is defect database. In test case database, what we can store is all the test cases. Then procedure to do the test case testing and history of their execution, how it is being stored in the TCDB. The next one is, it can be manual and also or automated. In DefectDB, it is also called as a defect database or the defect repository. It contains the details of all the defects that has been found in the product that are tested in various organization or in a particular organization. And test engineers can submit the defects in the defect repository for manual test cases. This automated test cases can be submitted automatically by using the automated framework. They will submit the defects in the corresponding defect repository. This green thick arrows, as shown in this green one, is called as the specific interactions between this framework and the external modules. This blue line shows the multiple interactions. This green line shows the specific interactions. Next topic is scenario and configuration file modules. Scenario is nothing but how we can execute our test case. That is called as a scenario. And configuration is set of variables that is used to execute the automation. That is configuration file, when it is important, means we need to run the test cases for various execution conditions, and we need to run the test cases for various different input and output conditions, and also for state conditions. Next one is test cases and the test framework modules. So in order to make the test framework to work, main thing is the test case. Test case, we can get the automated test cases from the TCDB. It is an object. It has been used for interacting with the other modules, not within that interaction with the test case itself. And test framework is a module that combines what to execute and how to execute. That is, it combines the test cases and the framework. Test framework is a module that combines what to execute and how it is to be executed. So it will just monitor the results of every iterations, and the results have been stored. And also, as it is the main logic for controlling all the modules, it has been very useful for the test framework modules. Next one is tools and the results modules. That is, in order to perform some of the operations in a test framework may need set of tools. That is, when we consider the test cases that is being stored as a source code files in the test case DB, these needs to be extracted and being compiled. So in order to run the compiled one, we need to have the runtime tools. So in that case, these tools will be useful. And whenever the test framework needs to run the set of test cases with a set of scenarios, we need to have a different set of values. So whatever the result for each of the test case along with the scenarios and the corresponding variable values chain needs to be stored for the future use. Next one is report generator and the reports or metrics modules. So once the test cases has been done and result is been available, we need to prepare the reports. That will be comes under this report generator and the reports or metrics modules. Here we can have three reports. First one is customized reports, that is executive report. Second one is technical report. It will give the moderate level of detail for the test to be run. Third one is detailed or debug reports that are generated for the developers to debug the failed test cases and their product. And this module, whichever takes the necessary inputs and prepare a report, is called as the report generator. Once the results have been available, this report generator generates the metrics. So once the reports have been generated, these reports and metrics modules, they need to store the corresponding reports for the future use. So that's all about it's been covered in this video. In next video, I just cover the next topic, that is generic requirements for test tool and also selecting the test tool. Thanks.